Hey, we're back in the ITC here at ABICOR Binzel's U.S. headquarters. So in the previous videos, we've been focused on the ABICAR Advanced. In this video, we're going to step it up to the ABICAR 1200 Pro. That opens us up to a lot of different possibilities with stitch welding, oscillation, and even the extended mass or the larger mass of the ABICAR Pro to use the dual torch setup. So we're going to start the same as we did with the Advanced, kind of going what's in the box, doing a straightforward setup, and how to program a pretty simple stitch weld. But say you place an order, what shows up in the box? So first of all, the ABICAR 1200 Pro, you're gonna have these simple guide rails and a torch holder. You're gonna have the power cable. This does not come off of the unit. We're also gonna have the trigger assembly wire. So let's get this torch set up. We're gonna use an automatic torch in this example. So just give me a minute while we set this up. So we have this all set up now. We're just using one of our ABICOR Binzel Aut torches. We have the power set up. We got the simple guide arms installed. We're going to use this to send the signal to the welding machine to start and stop the arc. So make sure that those are wired correctly. If you have any questions, you can reach out to us. All right, so both of the switches are neutral. We're able to power it up. And this is your main, your home screen. What we can do is we can select and save up to 40 different programs. You accomplish that by just holding down F2 here, and you're able to scroll through and you see it set up 1 through 12. But let's start with just setup one, okay? Hold F1 to configure the first. Hold it down, and now we're going to get to our first selectable screen. So it's going to set carriage speed, and we want to set it at 12 inches per minute. Okay, rotate that down to the second one. We're going to see the weld length, and it's going to be in inches. Now we want to move that to 3 inches. Because remember, we said our application is going to be a 3 on 9 inch center. Okay, so there's our weld length. Now it's going to ask for the skip. What is the difference between the end of weld one before the start of weld two? So if it's a 3 on 9, we just take 9 minus 3, half of one weld, half of the other. Do we need 6 inches in between the two? Just rotate that up to 6 inches. It's going to ask for a crater fill. So at the end of the weld, do we want it to stop? We're going to say no on this one. We can actually do a back step. We'll do that in the next video, but we're going to say 0 on this one. Total weld length, we're going to roll that all the way up to infinite. We can lower the current, or we can tell the welding machine to lower the current. We're going to skip that as no. We want the units in inches. Save setup. Hold down F2. Save setup done. Hold down F1. Takes us back to the beginning. Okay, so now to execute this 3 on 9 stitch weld, make sure we're in weld. And as soon as we click this, it's gonna weld for 3 inches. It's gonna go to high speed for the skip and then weld number 2. Let's send it on its way. Welding a 3 inch bead. There's the 6 inches in between. And now it's welding the second. So now, what if you wanted to do a 3 on 12? You set it up for a 3 on 9. How easy to just go back in and make a change to that? Real simple. Hold down F1. We're on the setup number 1, which is we did the 3 by 9. Hold that down. We still wanted the carriage speed of 12 inches per minute. We still want the weld length of 3 inches. Now the skip, we want 3 inch welds on 12 inch centers. Once again, 12 minus 3. Now this time what we're going to do is we're going to actually add a little bit of a crater fill. So at the end of the weld, we want it to stop for 0.2 seconds. And we want to back weld 0.3 inch. So at the end of the 3 inches, it's going to back step 0.3 inch and stop for 0.2 seconds. Total weld length, infinite. No current lowering. We want it in inches. Save setup number one, hold down F2. Save setup done, hold down F1. Get back to the main menu. Okay, now we're ready to execute this one. So now we've changed it to a 3-on-9 center. We have a back step and we have a crater fill. So let's send it on its way. Here's a 3-inch weld. Here's our 0.3-inch back weld, and there's our crater fill. It now goes off to the second weld. And essentially, that cycle is going to continue over and over and over again until you tell it to turn off. We also have these auto start stops. If you had a stopper on either end, the carriage will stop when it comes into contact with these. So as you can see, it's pretty straightforward to be able to program a simple stitch weld with the ABICAR 1200 Pro. So a couple things to keep in mind, right? Always double check the trigger attachment. Always make sure to keep those switches in neutral when you power the unit on. And then keep that angle of attack to kind of keep that car driving into the rail and that torch on track. As always, you can find this information on our website. Feel free to reach out to us with any questions or concerns you might have. And in the next video, what we're going to do is we're going to show you how to use the oscillator. We're going to attach that, go a little deeper into the programming, show you how effective that can be in tackling some of these larger gaps. Thanks, and we'll see you next time.